Okay. Let's demold this. Now I remember why I like to leave a little fabric hanging off and not cut it all off. Oh, there we go. There it is. A hollow molded tail. Very stiff. Just a little bit of sanding. Okay. There it is. Bottom. I need to cut out the elevator. Now, so where's mark top and bottom. Okay. A little mark on the trailing edge there. So I know what a straight line is. Razor saw again. To that line. Okay. quite to a line here. On the bottom, I'm going to actually put the hinge line a little bit forward of where it is on top, so there'll be room for the skin to fold up underneath it. Okay, now I use Dremel, cutoff wheel. First thing is to draw a straight line. Okay. I'd like a thinner pen for that. Where it needs to go. And this cut is a freehand. Sandpaper. Where's my sandpaper? Sand it. One's on both sides of the cut. Now it kind of wants to move, but to help that along, I'm going to mark in the top again. Okay. Okay, now we're open inside. And I'll try to clean that out. From the Dremel. Okay, plenty of elevator movement. Cigars and razor. Good. Now the last thing I do is put hinge tape on. Let me go grab the tape. This is a Tessa. It's polypropylene tape of some sort. I don't know exactly what it's used for, but it makes good hinge tape. It's hard to do this and try to film. Okay, you stick it on the rudder, I mean the elevator itself, and not on the stabilizer. Oops. Okay. And I'll kind of angle the ends a little bit so they don't get caught on something when they go in. Okay, now it's just as easy as just pushing it in underneath the skin. Kind of stubborn and sticky, so if you take some little micro balloons, just a little teeny bit, I'll just spread them around there. Takes all the tackiness away. Now it's gapped, it's got a hinge. The air will come right over. No air down underneath there. Done. Let's see what the whole plane looks like. Okay. I don't know if you can see the whole thing or not, but that's how this plane is gonna look. Just needs to be put together now. That's it. See ya.